Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a next problem set number 15. The earlier we learned about the word problem based on the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Now, today we are going to learn the word problems in which we have the more than one mathematical operations. Like, take an example. Suppose I brought a maths workbook for rupees 60, but my sir has told like we don't need to use that maths workbook, we have to make only a notebook, so that is unused to me. So how I can suffer that loss? That time my friend Ram want the same workbook, so I given to Ram, but as because that is unused for me, so I told him you have to take this workbook for the 50 rupees. So in this case, how much did I lose? Rupees 10. Means first I spent the amount to the shopkeeper and bought that workbook. After that, sell to the Ram at the loss of 10 rupees. Means first I have to multiply by 1 to get the cost price of that workbook. After that, I sold to the Ram, means deducted 50 from the 60, will get the answer 10. That is the loss I obtained. So this way, now whatever sums we have, in that we have more than one mathematical operation. To solve such kind of sums, what we have to do? First, read the sum carefully, try to understand what they are asking. After that, we have to work the given amount, the given ratios, whatever given things are there. We have to work on them, just think what we have to do to find out the answers. Let's start. Here we have the problem set number 16, question number 1. From a total of rupees 10,000. From a total of rupees 10,000, Anna donated rupees 7,000. Out of 10,000, 7,000 were donated to a school. The remaining amount, how will get the remaining amount? The total amount is 10,000. We have to subtract this 7,000, that is amount donated, will get the remaining amount. Was to be divided equally among 6 students. As the all-round student prize. So, what was the amount of this prize? Means we have to find out the amount of this prize. Means each and every student will get how much of the prize. So, let's start. First, we have to do the subtraction. 10,000. What is that? That is the total amount. After that, 7,000 we have to deduct. 7,000, that is donated amount. Now do the subtraction. This time we have to do the subtraction. 0 minus 0 0 minus 0 0 minus 0 0 minus 7, means it borrow 1 from this 1. 1 will become 0 and the 0 will become 10. 10 minus 7, 3. So we can say this 3,000, that is the remaining amount. Now we have to divide equally among the 6 students. Divide this amount among 6 students. Means now we are going to do the division of this 3000 by the divisor 6, as because we want to distribute that 3000 of amount within 6 students equally. So 6 5s are 30, subtract it, will get the 0. This 0 comes here, again 6 0s are 0, 0,
next zero will comes here, 6 zeros are 0, we'll get the remainder 0. Means we get the quotient 500. That means the amount of this price was rupees 500. We have to write the answer. The amount of price was rupees 500. This way we have to write the answer and conclude our sums. Now move for the next sum. Sum number 2. An amount of rupees 260 each. Each means this 260 is a price of 1. Was collected from 50 students. Number of students is 50. For a picnic. Means there are total 50 students and one student gave 260 rupees. So if we spend 11,450 were spent for picnic, what is the amount left over? So if we got the total number of amount what we collected and we subtract this spent amount, can we get the remaining amount what left over? Yes, let's start. So first we have to find out total number of amount. So that is how we'll get 260. This is amount of or collection of each students. Collection of each, or we can write 1 multiply by 50. What is this 50? Number of students. Now we have to do the multiplication. 0 0 is a 0, 0 6 is a 0, 0 2 is a 0. Now we have to start multiplication by this 5. 5 is at the tens place. So we should start in the next line writing the 0 at unit place. 5 0 is a 0, 5 6 is a 30, 3 carry, 5 2 is a 10 plus 3 13. Now we have to do the addition. We will get 0 0 0 3 1 13,000. This is total collection. We got rupees 13,000 of total collection. Now we want to find out the amount left over. So what we have to do? First we have to write the total collection. 13,000, that is total collection what we find it. Now we have to subtract how much what we spent, 11,450 spent amount. Do the subtraction. 0 minus 0, 0. Can we subtract 5 from 0? No. It borrow 1 from here. It also 0. It borrow 1 from 3. This 3 become 2 and this 0 become 10. Now this 10 gives 1 to this 0, it will become 9 and this 0 become 10. 10 minus 5, 5, 9 minus 4, 5, 2 minus 1, 1, 1 minus 1, 0. Thus we can say 1550 rupees were left. So it could be a amount left over. So now we have to write the answer in the form what they are asking. They are asking what is the amount left over. So the amount left over will be rupees 1550. This way we have to write the answer. Now proceed for the next sum. The third one. A shopkeeper bought a sack of 50 kg of sugar. Means what is the weight of that sack? 50 kg of one sack for rupees 1750. Means the price of 50 kg is 1750. As the price of sugar fell, he had to sell it at the rate of 32. Now at the time, as because the sugar price of the sugar will be
failed. So what he decided? He decided to sold that at the rate of 32 kg, 32 rupees per kg. How much less money did he get than he had spent? First, he spent 1750 for the sugar of 50 kg, but he sold it. If we can find the price, what at what he sold that all sugar, after that we have to subtract from the price of the cost. We'll get the answer. Yes, let's start. First, what was the, how much of the sugar in that one sack? That is 50 kg, 50 quantity, or we can say kg of sugar. Yes, multiply by 32 cost of per kg. Do the multiplication. 2 zeros are 0, 2 fives are 10. Now we have to start multiplying by 3, so put the 0 at unit place. 3 zeros are 0, 3 fives are 15. Do the addition. Whenever we are doing the addition, we will get 0, 0, 6, 1, 1600. That is amount received, or we can say selling amount. Yes, now we want to find out the how much will be he had get the less money. So how much he spent? He spent 1750. That is spent amount. Yes, subtract 1600. That is selling amount. Do the subtraction. 0 minus 0, 5 minus 0, 5, 7 minus 6, 1, 1 minus 1, 0. 150. What is it? It is a loss he bear. Now we have to write down the answer in the form what he asked. He is asking how much less money did he get? He get, or we can say he got rupees 150 less than he spent. He got rupees 150 less than he spent. Now move for the next sum. That is a shopkeeper bought 7 pressure cookers at the rate of rupees 1870. That is a price of one cooker, and how much cooker he bought? 7. He sold them all for total of rupees 14,230. Did he get less or more money than he had spent? In this sense also we want to find out the price, whether he bearing profit or loss. So first, start. First we want to find out the cost price of that 7 cooker. So 1870, that is price of the cost of 7 cooker. Cost of per cooker. This we have to write. Cost of one cooker, we can write of per cooker. Multiply by the 7. That is number of cooker. Do the multiplication. 7 zeros are 0, 7 sevens are 49, 4 carry, 7 eights are 56 plus 4, 60, 6 carry, 7 ones are 6 plus 7 ones are 7 plus 6, that is 13. So this 13,090 is what? That is at this price he brought. So cost price of 7 cookers. Cost price of 7 cookers. Now he sold that all at the rate of at the rupees 14,230. So how much did he get more or less? He get more. How much but?
So as because he sold that 14,230. That is selling price minus 13,090. That is cost price. Do the subtraction. 0 minus 0. We cannot subtract 9 from 3. It borrow 1 from 2. 2 become 1 and 3 become 13. 13 minus 9, 4. 1 minus 0, 1. 4 minus 3, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. That is 1140. What is that? More amount he got. Therefore, answer we have to write in the form what they are asking. Did he get less or more? He get rupees 1140 more than he spent. So this way we have to conclude our answer whether he is getting less or more amount.
So we learn how we have to solve the multiple operations of mathematics within a one word problem. First we read it, we got it, what they are given, and we decided what they want to answer, and for that what we have to find. And for finding that answer, which operations we have to do, whether we are going to do addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. So that is a very easiest way to solve such kinds of the sums. Read carefully, think about what they are asking and how we will get that answer and which operation we have to do for that. So you have the homework for today. Problem set number 16, we did question number 1, 2, 3 and 4, and question number 5 and 6 remains. These two questions you have to solve by your own. If still you have any doubt regarding these two sums, you should be asked in a group on Friday. Thank you so much.